Welcome to Cooper's Charms. This is potions class, so make sure you grab your standard size 2 pewter cauldron and turn to page 394. Oof. That can't be good, right? Currently in Wizards Unite, there are a total of 15 potions and 57 ingredients. However, in the beta versions of the games, there are only 7 potions and I believe 27 ingredients available to use. So first we'll talk about all of the potions that are currently available in the game, and then we'll go through all the ones that aren't currently available in the game and just kind of briefly touch on them because there is some missing information regarding what the ingredients are going to be for those or what their uses are. All of these infographics were created by OrangeWizard2019, whom you can follow on Instagram, and the link will be in the description box below. They have wonderful, wonderful infographics for just about everything you can think of in Wizards Unite. So the first potion that's available in the game is Brufio's Brain Elixir, which is going to be a staple for anybody trying to grind XP. This will double the amount of XP that you gain for anything that you do in the game for a total of 30 minutes. So it's the Wizards Unite equivalent to Lucky Eggs in Pokemon Go. This potion unlocks at level 4 and will take a total of 12 hours to brew. Now, I think it's important to note that with each potion, you can perform a series of master notes, which are basically a series of tapping, swiping, pinching, zooming, or shaking your phone in a particular order to reduce the time that it takes for your potion to brew. Each set of master notes is going to reduce your brew time by 15%. To figure that out, you just take the time that it takes for your potion to brew and multiply it by 85%, or 0.85. So the first ingredient in Brufio's Brain Elixir are 2 leaping toadstools, which are described as being more difficult to chop than its non-leaping counterparts. I can imagine. 2 frog brains, being described as very unpleasant. 2 runestone eggs, which increase mental agility. And powdered dragon claw, times 2, which is said to bring on cleverness. So that is the Brufio's Brain Elixir. The next potion is Dottle Draft, which will reduce the likelihood that a confoundable will flee with your foundable. This potion unlocks at level 17. Now that may seem like a really high level for that to occur at. Bear in mind that there are about 60 levels in this game, so 17 is not exactly too bad. This potion will take a total of 6 hours to brew, and then again, you can perform a set of master notes to knock off about 54 minutes off that time. The ingredients for this potion include 2 valerian root, which is known for its sedative properties, 2 soporiferous beans, which are known for its sleep-inducing properties, 1 butterscotch, which lends an alluring sweet scent to a potion's fumes, and 1 hermit crab shell, which does not currently have a description. The next potion is the Extimulo potion, which can be brewed 3 different ways at 3 different potencies. So you have the Extimulo potion, strong Extimulo potion, and the potent Extimulo potion. Each one of these potions is going to increase your spellcasting ability in a trace or combat as you go up in potency, as does your accuracy and effectiveness of your spellcast. The weakest Extimulo potion will unlock at level 4 and take 1 hour to brew. The ingredients include Riem blood, I think is how you say that. One of those. This is described as a rare and valuable ingredient that imbues magical strength. The next ingredient is Granian hair, pulled from the tail of a magnificent winged stallion. And you'll need one of those. Then you'll need 1 snowdrop, which is known for its resilience, and 1 bitterroot, which is known as a primary ingredient in Extimulo potions. In the strong Extimulo potion, this will unlock at level 10 and take 2 hours to brew. Its ingredients include 2 Rayam bloods, 1 Abraxan hair, which is taken from the mane of a winged Abraxan mare, 1 snowdrop, and 2 bitterroot, which again is in every Extimulo potion. And then for the potent Extimulo potion, this will be unlocked at level 20 and takes 6 hours to brew. The ingredients include 3 Rayam blood, 2 unicorn hair, which is taken from a unicorn, of course, and is also used in wands. Then you will need 4 snowdrops and 3 bitterroots. And then we have healing potions, which you are gonna need a ton of. This will restore your stamina that you have lost in combat. This will unlock at level 6, which makes sense because this is when you'll be able to choose a profession and participate in fortresses. This will take 1 hour to brew, and its ingredients include one dragon liver, which is known as a powerful ingredient and difficult to obtain. Maybe this will be one of the ingredients that's affected by weather. One wormwood, which is known as a bitter tasting ingredient. One bubo tuber pus, gross, which is squeezed from the pustules of a bubo tuber plant. That is so hard to say. And one dittany, which is known for its rejuvenation properties. Next, we have the wit sharpening spell, which unlocks at level 22 and will take 4 hours to brew. This potion will increase your spell's efficacy when you are battling in those fortresses against opponents like Death Eaters or magical beasts, etc., etc. Its ingredients include one ginger root, which is versatile and used in beautification brews, one newt spleen, which is described as a slimy ingredient, one ground scarab beetle, which is made from crushed carapaces of scarab beetles, and one armadillo bile, which has a remarkably putrid scent. How lovely. So that's all of the 7 potions that are currently in the game and the 27 ingredients that accompany them. Some of the potions that we know that exist but are not currently in the game include the Invigoration Draft that comes in a weak and a strong variation. These potions will grant focus for specialized abilities in wizarding challenges and reduces the ability cooldowns. Now, we haven't talked about abilities in wizarding challenges. That'll be in another video, but based on your profession, you have certain abilities. The one that comes to mind are that magic zoologists can actually heal some of the stamina lost for their teammates. The weak version of this invigoration draft will be unlocked at level 8 and take 10 minutes to brew. Again, you can perform those master notes to reduce that by 15%. Its ingredients include honey water, which is a standard ingredient in all variations of invigoration drafts, vervain infusion, one of those, has healing properties. One scurvy grass, which is also a standard ingredient in all variations of invigoration drafts. And one lovage, which is an ingredient in a weaker invigoration draft. Then we have the strong invigoration draft, which is going to grant significant focus for those specialized abilities. This one will unlock at level 13 and take 30 minutes to brew. Its ingredients also include one honey water, one vervain infusion, one scurvy grass, but will have 2 sneeze warts, which will greatly increase the effectiveness of the invigoration draft. The next set of potions we have a description for, but not its ingredient list. The first one is a memory potion, which will yield extra family XP from each trace that you complete. I'll post the infographic here so that you know what information we know about the memory potion. The next potion that we have is the Wide Eye potion, which improves your speed and accuracy, producing a perfect spell cast. Why is this one not available yet? And finally, the ones that we don't have a lot of information on include the Scintillation potion, Felix Felicis, Bountiful Brew, and the Draft of Perception. Those are all of the 15 potions that are in the game's data currently. Now again, there are only 27 ingredients currently in the game. Some of the ingredients that we found in the game data that are not in the game include that is a lot of ingredients not currently in the game, and I'm sure they have something to do with the other 8 potions, but there's a lot of potion making in this game. Now, if you would like to learn a little bit more about some of the ingredients used in these potions, I highly recommend Wizard Trick's ingredients series. He has so far taken a few ingredients, which I will list right here, and he goes through some of the individual ingredients in a little bit more detail. So I will link him in the description box below and definitely go check him out. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. I hope you learned a little bit more about potions and their ingredients. And if you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, why not subscribe? You're already here. I appreciate you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Knox.